Princeton biologists have discovered a way some cells pass genetic information to their offspring outside the path regulated by DNA. Their experiments, with possible implications for humans, have focused on a single-celled organism that lives in ponds. Science and Technology correspondent Patrick Regan reports.
The evidence suggests that an organism, at least this one, a common pond dweller called Oxytricha, can inherit traits that its parents have acquired during their lives, traits not encoded in the parents' DNA. This single-celled critter is the star of the show in Laura Landweber's lab because of the puzzling way its genetic information passes from one generation to the next.
It doesn't have an elegant partitioning of its information into units, at least when it's born, so to speak, at the beginning of its development. Instead, it actually has to fish a piece from over there and a piece from over there in its genome and maybe one from over there and put them all together, piece one, two, and three.
Landweber and colleagues, including postdoctoral researchers Mariusz Nowacki and E. Joe, caught these cells in the act of using what she calls a secret code, instruction book, or cheat sheet for reassembling the scrambled genome. It's a temporary but vital template made from DNA's chemical cousin, RNA. The researchers proved this by throwing a molecular monkey wrench into the mechanism, which broke in a precisely predicted way. Then they put their own handle on the machine by programming an artificial RNA molecule and injecting it into Oxytricha cells, which passed it on to their offspring.
It's as if you're taking a raw tape of film. You can simply recut the film and make it a slightly different story. Now you introduce story to the cell, and the cell accepts the story, and what's more interesting is the progeny of such a genetically engineered cell keep telling the same story that you introduced into it.
The idea that the same mechanism might play a role in other cells, particularly in the human body, has inspired some to anticipate possibilities like reprogramming cancer cells or priming the immune system.
But we don't know if this particular discovery that's applied to a single-celled microorganism is going to turn out to be very general or might instead be something quirky to this organism, which might even explain its evolutionary success and why you can find it all over the globe.
Patrick Regan, NJN News, Princeton.